In a move that has shaken the military world, China recently unveiled its most advanced naval laser weapon system, the LY-1. This weapon's display is not just a technological show, but also a bold statement to the world that the era of directed energy warfare has truly begun. While previously ballistic missiles, stealth fighters, or aircraft carriers were symbols of military supremacy, the spotlight now shifts to laser weapons that operate at the speed of light. The LY-1 marks a turning point in the global arms race, from the dominance of explosive engines to the era of photons and pure energy. The modern arms race is no longer simply about who has the fastest missile or the largest aircraft carrier. China recognizes that the future of warfare lies in disruptive technologies capable of surpassing conventional systems. Over the past few decades, Beijing has invested heavily in directed energy research, integrating resources from the military, defense industry, and academia. This focus is not without reason. The world now faces new threats such as suicide drones, loitering munitions, low-flying high-speed cruise missiles, and drone swarm attacks. All of these are difficult to counter with expensive interceptor missiles alone. By comparison, an anti-air missile can cost millions of dollars per unit, while a single laser shot requires only a fraction of the cost of electricity. In terms of economics and efficiency, lasers offer an unmatched cost-effective defense ratio. The arrival of the LY-1 is the culmination of this long investment. It is not only a testament to technological success, but also a symbol of the shift in the Chinese military paradigm, from playing catch-up to becoming a leader at the forefront of the weapons revolution. Although the technical details of the LY-1 are closely guarded, military observers suspect the system is capable of emitting enough energy to disable a target within seconds, even milliseconds. The speed of light is key. Once a sensor detects a threat, the laser can be fired instantly, without the need for a missile to wait for travel time. The LY-1 has two main operating modes. 1. Soft kill, non-physical disablement. The laser is directed at the target's optical sensors, cameras, or navigation systems. An armed drone, for example, could lose its ability to see or lock onto a target because its systems are blinded. Even cruise missiles that rely on infrared imaging could be deviated from their course and crash before reaching their target. 2. Hard kill, physical destruction. At higher intensities, the laser can directly incinerate target structures. Small drones, light-powered speedboats, and even certain missile warheads can melt or burn up within seconds. The LY-1's effectiveness is even more pronounced when facing a saturation attack. In a scenario where tens or hundreds of drones are launched simultaneously, conventional missile systems would be overwhelmed. But with a laser, as long as an energy source is available, the weapon can fire continuously without the need to reload ammunition. Although first showcased on a land-based platform, the LY-1's naval designation clearly indicates its maritime orientation. In the world of naval warfare, the presence of lasers can be a game-changer. Imagine a Chinese destroyer sailing in the South China Sea, surrounded by the threat of surveillance drones and anti-ship missiles. With the LY-1's laser system, the ship could create an invisible energy shield. Any approaching target could be disabled without causing a major explosion or wasting limited missile reserves. Another important advantage is logistics. A missile-carrying ship can only operate for a limited period before having to return to base for recharging. However, with a laser weapon, the only requirement is a power source, which can be obtained from a generator or even a nuclear reactor on the aircraft carrier. This allows for longer, more flexible, and far more efficient naval operations. The presence of the LY-1 carries broader strategic implications than just technological innovation. If this system proves effective in combat trials, the dominance of Western navies, particularly the United States, will face serious challenges. The US and its allies will certainly not stand idly by. The presence of the LY-1 has the potential to trigger a directed energy arms race. Washington itself has been developing a laser weapons program for warships, but the fact that Beijing has already boldly showcased its product demonstrates a high level of confidence. In the Indo-Pacific region, the situation could change drastically. This technology gives China an asymmetric advantage, especially in maritime disputes. If one side can deploy a laser-based defense dome, its opponent will be forced to explore new strategies, perhaps even completely altering its warfighting doctrine. Despite its promise, the LY-1 is not without its drawbacks. Atmospheric factors such as fog, heavy rain, or thick clouds can reduce the effectiveness of the laser beam. The light energy can be fragmented, absorbed, or scattered, drastically reducing its destructive power. Furthermore, long-term laser use poses heat management challenges. The higher the laser intensity, the greater the heat generated. If the cooling system is inadequate, internal components can be damaged. Furthermore, the enormous energy requirements require a stable power supply on board warships. However, technological trends indicate that these obstacles can be overcome. Innovations in high-capacity batteries, supercapacitors, and even mini-nuclear reactors are making large-scale laser deployment increasingly realistic. Thus, the LY-1 may be just the beginning of a revolution in directed energy warfare. The LY-1 is more than just a new weapon. It symbolizes a transformation in modern warfare. By harnessing the power of directed energy, China is seeking to assert itself as a pioneer in the 21st century military race. This weapon has the potential to transform naval strategy, challenge Western dominance, and spark a new chapter in global geopolitics. The laser era is upon us. The question is no longer whether weapons like the LY-1 will be used on the battlefield, but when the world will witness the debut of true directed energy combat.